speaking with Lachlan Wallace this morning from Hillgrove Resources. Lachlan, good morning.
Hi, Andrew. Great to be here.
Got some big news this week, Lachlan, around this institutional placement. We'll get onto that in a moment, but just firstly, give us a quick bit of background here on the project at Kanmantoo.
Absolutely. So the Kanmantoo Copper Project's located about 55 kilometres from Adelaide. We had open pit operations that ran from the site from about 2011 to 2020. During that period, we produced about 137,000 tonnes of copper in concentrate, as well as 10,000 ounces of gold. And since 2020, we've been drilling to establish the viability of an underground mine. And in 2021, we released our first feasibility study. And then since then, we've continued to drill. And this week, we released an updated economic assessment to incorporate some of the drilling that we did last year. And this really shows that the initial project can generate over $200 million in free cash post-tax in the first 4 years and requires a very low capital of only $25 million, owing really to a combination of existing infrastructure. We have a 3.6 million tonne per annum process facility, as well as the tailing storage, and as well as the close proximity of the mineralisation from the portal, which we've already commenced. So the underground is fully permitted, enjoys excellent support from the nearby community. So with all the infrastructure and permitting in place, the project is really well positioned for a fast, low capital restart with first copper production aiming at the end of this year or early next.
Right. So tell us more, Lachlan, about this week's capital raise.
Yeah. So yesterday we announced a $39 million equity funding package, which really facilitates the commencement of the Kanmantoo underground operation, along with continued mine expansion drilling. So equity-based funding enables this project to start without any debt. So whilst I acknowledge that it does result in dilution, we actually had 70% of the funding provided from existing shareholders. And for a ramp-up, just equity is a far superior outcome. And first and foremost, having no debt repayment schedule really provides us with significant operational flexibility, which de-risks the mining ramp-up phase. Also, really, the cost of debt has actually increased with recent interest rate rises and general capital tightening, such that there's really been a convergence with the cost of debt and the cost of equity, with debt no longer being the cheapest option in all cases. And I guess finally, having no debt covenants really reduces the restrictions on the company in terms of distributing dividends and thereby potentially enabling us to bring those timing of dividend payments forward. And this is quite important because Hillgrove holds over $17 million in franking credits, which enables us to distribute around $50 million in fully frank dividend. So we had really excellent uptake for the placement participation. We had about 70%, as I said, going to existing shareholders. Really demonstrates strong support for the project, particularly from our Freepoint, who are a significant shareholder. They are our offtake partner. And as part of this placement, they'll actually increase their position to just under 20%. They've been a long-standing partner of Hillgrove and were part of the project for many years, really dating right back to the early days of the open pit development. And their leadership in this placement really demonstrates their strong commitment to the development of the underground, as well as an appreciation of the on-lease exploration upside. And I guess importantly, the quantum of funding enables both sufficient operational contingency to get this underway, you know, only $25 million, so one of the lowest capital intensive development projects on offer at the moment, but it also gives us enough money to get on with a serious exploration budget to enable that mine expansion drilling with the view of both increasing mine life as well as expanding the annual throughput. So many of your listeners probably would be aware, but the current drilling at the moment is really limiting the size of the mine plan. So we have demonstrated that the drilling extends about 500 metres below the base of the pit, but the mine plan itself only extends 250 metres below the main pit and only 150 metres below Nugent. And this is really due to a lack of drilling density. So both these areas remain open at depth. And with this exploration drilling continuing both in parallel with the development stage, you know, we would expect to be able to replace both resource depletion as well as extend that mine life well beyond this initial stage.
Well, tell us a bit more, Lachlan. What's the plan as far as moving the project forward over the next 12 months?
Yeah, so we have a really exciting news flow over the next 12 months. Obviously, we've just updated that initial mine plan. Once we conclude this SPP, is a $3 million SPP as part of the transaction, we'll get on with those early works. We've already started some of those mobilisation works, and that'll conclude next quarter. I would anticipate that next quarter, we are starting those first development cuts. Because we have started those portals and already done some of that development, we're literally walking in on the first day and taking a 4.2 metre cut. So very quick restart. That enables us to be producing copper towards the end of this year or early next. Whilst that's happening, we are ramping up our drilling program. At the moment, the drill rig is mobilizing to site. And the idea there is to both continue doing the depth extension drilling as well as target a couple of new areas called North Hub and South Hub with a view to bring these in with maiden resource estimates planned for the third quarter of this year. Of course, we get to the end of this year, we're obviously commencing the underground stoping, so producing ore, taking it to the ROM pad, making sure that we have enough development headings available to warrant turning the mill back on. I think that'll be towards the end of this year or early next. And then we're into cash flows from first copper production. So yeah, really, really strong news flow ahead for the next 12 months.
Lots planned. Good to see you, Lachlan. Thanks very much.
Thanks for your time, Andrew.